school fights, teenage pregnancies, youth gangs, 18-year-old girls getting beat up by teenage boys, and youth prisons were some of the topics we touched on tonight. However, one night will never, never be long enough to show you the impact of fatherlessness and how it has affected so many young men and women. Listen, everything stems from our childhood. Think about it. No kid ever tells their parent or teacher that when they grow up, they want to be in a gang, or robbing stores, hurting, murdering people, or selling drugs at the corner store. Or when they grow up, they want to give themselves to anybody and everybody, and fall pregnant to a guy who wants them to abort the child. You see, the first couple of years as a child is the most important years. But sadly, due to trauma these kids have faced, we are now in the predicament that we are in today, a fatherlessness generation, yearning for a father's love. Please hear our hearts when we say tonight, it's not about highlighting everything our fathers did wrong, but simply giving you a glimpse from a youth's perspective. It's also not about disregarding our beautiful mothers, grandmothers, aunties, and sisters who play both roles. I'ma keep it 100. Women are freaking amazing, and we salute every single one of them for holding it down for the family. But when asked what is the solution to healing the hurting youth of this generation, the truth of the matter is that it's their fathers. They are the solution to healing the hurting youth and restoring the families.
You see, what a father carries is so pivotal to a child's identity, growth, and success. When a father validates his daughter by instilling into her that she is more valuable than rubies and pearls, she will never have to go searching for what love looks like through another, because she would see her dad and how he treats her mother. You are a daughter of a king and a call to more than just makeup, hair, clothes, or shoes. You were made in his image. No one can do what you do. Or when a father gives affection, acceptance, and affirmation to a son, like telling him at the age of 8, my son, you have the potential to be great, and don't let anyone get in your way. You were born for greatness. There is no one like you in this world. You have a fire so fierce no one can put out. You carry the spirit of confidence and boldness, not a trace of doubt. I will forever be proud of the man you will become, but more so the privilege of having you as my son. If more fathers did this, our world would be a better place. However, it is not too late to change this. How do I know? Because I know of a cause that are raising fathers to save their children. And through this movement, I know there are many amazing men who are great fathers. To the fathers and those who have been a positive role model and are currently standing in the gap to play this role in so many young kids' lives, whether you're an uncle, a big brother, a youth mentor, school teacher, we honor you. I would also like to make a special acknowledgement to the men who are working their hardest to rekindle their relationships with their kids, and the men who are working to better themselves for the benefit of their children.
For some of us who don't have that, we've had someone else stand in that gap and play that role. And for many of us, that is you, our apostle, Bishop Brian Tamaki. Real talk. Statistics shows that half of the Youth Nation kids should be ministers of society, in jail, even dead. Half of us kids have never had a father figure. And I can say that because I'm one of those kids. I was 10 years old when my father left, but because I was connected to something greater than myself, I can stand here proudly alongside every youth who hasn't had a father figure and honor you as our spiritual father. But also every father here tonight, regardless if you have children, been an active male role model in someone's life, an uncle, a cousin, a big brother, Keep being there for your families, especially these kids, because without you, the stories you saw tonight will continue to be a reality. And we need you. We need you to not give up and stand up and take your place as a man and become the man that God created you to be.